Hey University, welcome back to the channel. It's a girl Vermore and I'm back with another reaction video. Today guys, I'm going to be reacting to insightful report, and this is The View triggered as Donald Trump Jr. calls them out for their hypocrisy on live TV. For their hypocrisy, like gosh, The View, they are hypocrites. I'm so sorry to say this, but they are, because majority of their videos that I have seen and reacted to, gosh, it is really, I don't even know how to explain it. Gosh, anyway, this is my first time checking this out and I want to check it out with you guys. But before we get started, we have some amazing people watching us for the first time. If you are new to this channel, hello, I'm Vera. I do reaction videos. If it is something that you love, why not join Vera City? Hit the subscribe button below, turn on the post notification bell so you can always be the first person to know whenever a new video drops. And thanks, guys, let's go.
Are you questioning my character?
I'm not questioning your character. I'm talking about you're questioning my father's character.
And I say, we all have done insane things. I didn't question anybody.
That's Donald Trump Jr. fact-checking the women on The View. And things get extremely heated.
Wow.
He calls them out for being the hypocrites that they are.
You've worn blackface. Whoopi,
no,
you said that Roman Polanski.
I'm sorry, and don't.
You said that Roman Polanski, it wasn't rape when he raped it.
Okay, sorry. Can they just allow one person to talk at a time? Like, come on, you guys are no barbarians. Can you just allow one person to talk at a time? Come on. You guys are grown-ups. Gosh.
Child. So
let's talk about this so you don't bring this up. The question came up.
I did not go in blackface, please.
No, she was not in blackface.
Thank you.
Sorry, listen, being black, I recognize blackface, I can say. Okay? I know what
you're
saying.
Back me up on that.
What are they clapping for?
Now that you've broken this piece of ice, because I guess this is the fight you want.
Wow.
It's not the fight
I want. Yeah, it is.
But if we're talking about character, if we're talking about these things.
Are you questioning my character?
I'm not questioning your character. I'm talking about, you're questioning my father's character. And I say, we all have done insane
things. I didn't question anybody.
He was clearly prepared for the onslaught when he entered the lion's den known as The View. He was already anticipating the
burrow. Oh my god! She said it's the lion's den. It's really the lion's den, yeah? I love the fact that he came prepared. He came ready. He knew what he was in for. And he was giving it to her. Hot. As she's giving it to him, he's giving it to her straight up. I love that. Smart man.
Barrage of questions that would veer off topic from his book.
Recently, you've been very outspoken about how Hunter Biden has benefited from nepotism.
Yes.
And you say, I wish my name was Hunter Biden. I could make millions off of my father's presidency.
Yeah.
And your father tweeted this. He said, your father encourages people to buy your book. I think that's benefiting from your dad's presidency. But not that my opinion matters. But let's talk about 2020, because you do talk about 2020 in your book.
The show?
How do you... 2020. He talks about 2020.
Can I address Hunter Biden
ABC
first?
Because, plug.
Listen, I get that I'm the son of a rich guy from New York. I understand that. My father has done a lot. You know, I've benefited from that as Hunter Biden has. The difference is we did that as a private company. When we got into international politics, the second my father won the presidency, he said, we will not do new foreign deals going forward. Hunter Biden utilized his father's vice presidency to magically end up on a board in Ukraine with a language he doesn't speak, on a business he knows nothing about, for $83,000
a month.
If I did that, you guys would lose your mind. Well, understandably.
Because the DC hotel, your father's DC hotel, opened up just a couple of weeks after his election.
I'm glad you asked.
And you've actually made, I think, according to your father's financial report, he earned about $40.8 million. Just a minute, from his D.C. hotel in 2018. The attorney general is going to hold a $30,000 holiday party at the D.C. hotel. A lobbying firm with ties to the Saudi government paid $270,000 to the hotel between October 2016 and March 2017.
There's nice hall.
Well, listen,
let me
say
he's president. He knows how to make
the
bucks.
But I'm glad you brought it up.
So,
these are
so
the details.
Bottom line is you have made money.
But let me finish. These are the details that the media always neglects. Yes, we're in the hotel business. We have been for decades. Yeah. That's not a secret. When we take money from a foreign entity, in D.C., most of it's foreign entities, right? Yeah. The government-related foreign entities, when they come, we literally stroke a check back to the U.S. Treasury. Mm-hmm. We spend more money on accountants than we can make from this to make sure we're doing that right, because we can't do that. My father gives back his entire salary to the U.S. Treasury to be put towards causes, whether it was alcoholism, whether it was the Department of Interior. So we're literally not making money from any of those foreign governments. We're giving it back to the Treasury. And by the way,
but
there's an opportunity.
But you are making money from the hotel based on the
presidency. We're in the hotel business.
So, right, nothing to,
like, we're giving back.
Why are they cutting him off? You see the question, you didn't allow him to land, you don't allow him to talk. And Whoopi is already ringing the bell. What is she ringing the bell for? This woman, once you don't agree with them, they tend to just disrupt the whole thing. Come on. Six women against one man. Yeah, they are unable to hold him down. Start ringing the bell. What are you ringing the bell for?
Did you notice how Trump Jr. strategically brought up Joy Behar's past controversial actions, such as dressing up as a black woman, a move that many would find offensive? While this tactic may seem divisive, it ultimately showcased Trump Jr.'s ability to navigate contentious topics and steer the conversation in his favor. By highlighting instances of hypocrisy and double standards, he effectively demonstrated his mastery of political maneuvering. He found himself in a position where he had to constantly defend himself and deflect certain accusations. The women on the panel continuously interrupted him, making it difficult for any semblance of civil discourse. It's clear to me that the interview lacked courtesy and focus. They didn't even ask him about his book, which should have been the primary topic of discussion. It's basic courtesy to address why someone is appearing on the show and then proceed accordingly. Disregarding this not only shows a lack of respect, but also undermines the purpose of the interview. And it's just another example of how wicked these women are.
This is crazy. They didn't even talk about his book. And that is even the main reason why he's on the show. Like, they didn't even talk about his book. Like, come on. Ladies, what is wrong? What is wrong with this woman? Donald Trump Jr. In fact, the apple does not fall. There's a saying that the apple does not fall far from the tree. Is a true son of his father. I love the way he handled the situation. He handled the women. He gave them their size. And they couldn't hold him. They couldn't outwin him. So they started making the bell. Oh, come on. I keep saying this. The View, that show needs to be shut down completely. They didn't even talk about his book, which is really disrespectful. They only brought him there to come and attack him. At the end of the day, he still won. He won the argument. Like, I mean, why would Sonny Ost bring out, why would she bring out Trump's hotel business into the conversation? Were they there to discuss about Trump's hotel business? Who's their business with that? Instead of them to talk about his book, they're talking about something else. Because they want to use that to tie him down. Anyways, thank God he was able to answer them clearly, to show that they have nothing to hide. They've got nothing under their sleeves. I really love that. Who's their business with his hotel? For goodness sakes. They are still the ones that said men are useless. In fact, from that their statement alone is... Oh, gosh. I don't even know who watches this show. Are people actually watching The View? Even their audience. Goodness, this is just crazy. I don't know what to say again at this point. What do you guys think about this video? Drop a comment down below. If you enjoyed this video, give it a huge thumbs up and please share this video. If you're new to the channel, join Veracity. Hit the subscribe button below, turn on the post notification bell so that you can always be the first person to know whenever a new video drops. And that's guys. See you in the next one. Bye guys.